video is completely owned by Mansoor, the director of Mansoor Studio. Resting membrane potential. It is defined as the electrical potential difference, voltage, across the cell membrane, between inside and outside of the cell, under resting condition. The following factors cause or contribute to establishment and maintenance of resting membrane potential. Sodium-potassium pump selective permeability of cell membrane. Action potential. It is defined as a series of electrical changes that occur in the membrane potential when the muscle or nerve is stimulated. Phases of action potential. Depolarization stage. It is the initial phase of action potential in which inside of the cell becomes positive and outside becomes negative. At this time, the membrane suddenly becomes permeable to sodium ions, allowing tremendous numbers of positively charged sodium ions to diffuse to the interior of the axon. The normal polarized state of minus 70 millivolts is immediately neutralized by the inflowing positively charged sodium ions, with the potential rising rapidly in the positive direction, a process called depolarization. In large nerve fibers, the great excess of positive sodium ions moving to the inside causes the membrane potential to actually overshoot beyond the zero level and to become somewhat positive. In some smaller fibers, as well as in many central nervous system neurons, the potential merely approaches the zero level and does not overshoot to the positive state. The normal polarized state of minus 70 millivolts is immediately neutralized by the inflowing positively charged sodium ions, with the potential rising rapidly in the positive direction, a process called depolarization. When the firing level is reached, the influx of Na+ is very great and it leads to overshoot. But the Na+ transport is short-lived. It is because of rapid inactivation of Na+ channels. Thus, the Na+ channels open and close quickly. At the same time, the K+ channels start opening. This leads to efflux of K+ out of the cell, causing repolarization. Unlike the Na+ channel, the K+ channels remain open for longer duration. These channels remain open for a few more milliseconds after completion of repolarization. It causes efflux of more number of K+, producing more negativity inside. It is the cause for hyperpolarization. Initiation of the action potential 1. Positive feedback cycle opens the sodium channels. First, as long as the membrane of the nerve fiber remains undisturbed, no action potential occurs in the normal nerve. However, if any event causes enough initial rise in the membrane potential from minus 70 millivolts toward the zero level, the rising voltage will cause many voltage-gated sodium channels to begin opening. This occurrence allows rapid inflow of sodium ions, which causes a further rise in the membrane potential, thus opening still more voltage-gated sodium channels and allowing more streaming of sodium ions to the interior of the fiber. This process is a positive feedback cycle that, once the feedback is strong enough, continues until all the voltage-gated sodium channels have become activated. Then, within another fraction of a millisecond, the rising membrane potential causes closure of the sodium channels and opening of potassium channels, and the action potential soon terminates. A sudden rise in membrane potential of about 15 millivolts is usually required. Therefore, a sudden increase in the membrane potential in a large nerve fiber from minus 70 millivolts up to about minus 55 millivolts usually causes the explosive development of an action potential. This level of minus 55 millivolts is said to be the threshold for stimulation of nerve fiber. Direction of propagation. An excitable membrane has no single direction of propagation, but the action potential travels in all directions away from the stimulus, even along all branches of a nerve fiber until the entire membrane has become depolarized. All or nothing principle. Once an action potential has been elicited at any point on the membrane of a normal fiber, the depolarization process travels over the entire membrane if conditions are right, but it does not travel at all if conditions are not right. This principle is called the all or nothing principle, and it applies to all normal excitable tissues. Occasionally, the action potential reaches a point on the membrane at which it does not generate sufficient voltage to stimulate the next area of the membrane. When this situation occurs, the spread of depolarization stops. Therefore, for continued propagation of an impulse to occur, the ratio of action potential to threshold for excitation must at all times be greater than 1. This greater than 1 requirement is called the safety factor for propagation. Refractory period, it is the period at which the nerve does not give any response to a stimulus. Refractory period is of two types. 1. Absolute refractory period, which is the period during which the nerve does not show any response at all, whatever may be the strength of stimulus. Summation, it is the combination of two or more subliminal stimuli which are applied to a nerve fiber within about 0.5 milliseconds to produce a response. Adaptation, it is a phenomenon in which a nerve fiber has been stimulated continuously and the excitability is greater in the beginning, but later, the response gradually decreases until the nerve fiber does not show any response at all. It is also known as accommodation. Its cause is when a nerve fiber is stimulated continuously, depolarization occurs continuously. Continuous depolarization inactivates the sodium pump and increases the efflux of potassium ions. Membrane stabilizing factor, they are excitability inhibitors and include high ECF calcium ion local anesthetics, e.g. procaine and tetracaine.